अकाउंट्स फ्रॉम इनकम्प्लीट रिकॉर्ड्स, क्लास 11 अकाउंटेंसी। हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न वन न्यू चैप्टर, अकाउंट्स फ्रॉम इनकम्प्लीट रिकॉर्ड्स। आप सभी को पता होगा, इन अकाउंटेंसी वी गिव टू इफेक्ट ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी ट्रांजेक्शन। दैट मीन्स वी फॉलो डबल एंट्री बुक कीपिंग सिस्टम। As per the duality concept, we record every transaction at minimum two places. But today we are going to learn accounts from incomplete records, which is also known as single entry system. But it is not actually single entry system because there is no such system. There is a double entry bookkeeping system. So let us begin this chapter, accounts from incomplete records. Now, what is accounts from incomplete records? Accounting records which are not strictly kept according to double entry system are known as incomplete records. That means, if the accounts are not prepared as per the double entry bookkeeping system, then it is known as incomplete records. Normally, under this system, records of cash transactions and personal accounts of debtors and creditors are properly maintained, while the information regarding assets, liabilities, expenses, and revenues is partially recorded. Hence, these are usually referred as incomplete records, and many authors describe it as a single entry system. So there are some people who do not maintain complete account, but they give only the one effect, either debit effect or credit effect, or sometimes they give both the effect, debit as well as credit. They do not maintain complete record. So for them, it is a accounts from incomplete records. What is single entry system? Single entry system is used by small firms that have just started business. Single entry accounting system records only one side of every transaction. Say for example, rupees 5000 is received from Mr. X. So they will record rupees 5000 received from Mr. X in their book. They do not give any two effect of this transaction like cash account debit to Mr. X. In double entry system, we give two effect, whereas in single entry system or in accounts from incomplete records, they give only one effect of the transaction. This happens because they use only one entry to record every transaction. So they will write cash received from Mr. X. Therefore, single entry system does not use nominal and real account. Single entry system records only transactions that the firm is undertaking with external parties. What are the features of incomplete records? So the first point is, it is unsystematic method, because here we do not record every transaction systematically. Second point, generally, records for cash transactions and personal accounts are properly maintained, and other accounts are not properly maintained. So in this method, only cash transactions, that means cash received and cash paid, are properly recorded, as well as the personal accounts of the debtors and creditors are properly maintained. Third point, personal transactions of owner may also be recorded in the cash book. That means capital brought by the owner, amount withdrawn by the owner, etc. are recorded by them. Different organizations maintain records according to their convenience and need, and their accounts are not comparable due to lack of uniformity. So different people in a different way. They prepare their books of account in a different way in their regional language. So we can't compare their books of account because they do not follow any systematic method of recording. They do not follow any accounting principle. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, टू एसरटेन द प्रॉफिट और लॉस और फॉर ऑब्टेनिंग एनी अदर इंफॉर्मेशन नेसेसरी फिगर्स कैन बी कलेक्टेड ओनली फ्रॉम ओरिजिनल वाउचर्स सच एज सेल्स इनवॉइस परचेस इनवॉइस एटसेट्रा. एज द प्रॉपर रिकॉर्ड्स आर नॉट मेंटेन्ड नेसेसरी इंफॉर्मेशन दे कलेक्ट ओनली फ्रॉम द अवेलेबल वाउचर्स. द प्रॉफिट और लॉस फॉर द ईयर कैन नॉट बी एसरटेन अंडर दिस सिस्टम विद अ हाई डिग्री ऑफ एक्यूरेसी एज ओनली एन एस्टिमेट ऑफ द प्रॉफिट अर्न और लॉस इनकर्ड कैन बी मेड बिकॉज दे हैव नॉट मेंटेन द प्रॉपर रिकॉर्ड ऑफ द एक्सपेंसिस एंड ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ इनकम्स एंड दैट्स वाई इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू प्रिपेयर ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट एंड प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट सो एग्जैक्ट अमाउंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट और लॉस कैन नॉट बी असर्टेन. सिमिलरली द बैलेंस शीट ऑल्सो मे नॉट रिफ्लेक्ट द कंप्लीट एंड ट्रू पोजिशन ऑफ एसेट्स एंड लायबिलिटीज. नाउ वाई दे प्रिफर इनकम्प्लीट रिकॉर्ड, सो वी कैन ऑल्सो से वट आर द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ दिस. सो द फर्स्ट reason is this system can be adopted by people who do not have the proper knowledge of accounting principles. They do not know how to record the transactions, how to debit, how to credit, and that's why they follow this system. Second reason, it is inexpensive method. Cost involved is low as specialized accountants are not appointed by the organizations. So the second reason for following this system is it is inexpensive method. It does not require any appointment of accountant for recording the transactions. Third, it is a time saving method. Time consumed in maintaining record is less as only a few books are maintained. They maintain only the cash accounts and personal account of the debtors and creditors. So it saves time. Next is it is a convenient mode of maintaining records as the owner may record only important transactions according to the need of the business. So these are the reasons. Now what are the limitations? The first limitation is as double entry system is not followed, a trial balance cannot be prepared and accuracy of account cannot be ensured because they do not have information of all the accounts. So trial balance cannot be prepared. Second limitation, correct assessment on and evaluation of financial result, that means profit or loss of business operations, cannot be made. It is difficult to find exact amount of profit or loss because they do not have maintained any record of, or we can say proper record of, expenses and incomes. Next limitation, analysis of profitability, liquidity and solvency of the business cannot be done. You can't analyze trend in the profitability of the business, short-term debt paying capacity, liquidity of business, long-term debt paying capacity, that means solvency of the business. And this may cause a problem in raising fund from outsiders, that means from banks, and planning future business activities. Next limitation is the owner face great difficulty in filing an insurance claim with an insurance company in case of loss of inventory by fire or theft. Because he does not have complete record of the stock, he does not have complete record of the assets. So in case of fire and theft, it becomes difficult for the owner to file a claim for the insurance from the insurance company. It becomes difficult to convince the income tax authorities also about the reliability of the computed income because they have not maintained all the records, so they can't convince income tax department for the income tax return filed by them. So these are the different limitations of incomplete records. Now the question is, how they will find their profit or loss? So there are two methods of ascertainment of profit or loss. This type of organizations who do not maintain complete record, how can they find their profit or loss? So for that, there are two methods. To ascertain the profit or loss for the particular accounting year and to determine the financial position of an entity at the end of the year from the available information in the incomplete record, the following two methods are followed. The first method is preparing the statement of affairs at the beginning and at the end of the accounting period, which is known as statement of affairs method, or also known as net worth method. Second method is preparing trading and profit and loss account and balance sheet by putting the accounting records in a proper order, which is known as conversion method. So there are two methods of calculating profit or loss. One is statement of affairs method and second is conversion method. So let us understand both the methods with the help of examples. First method, preparing statement of affairs. Now what is statement of affairs? Statement of affair is nothing but it is similar to balance sheet. Like balance sheet, we prepare opening statement of affairs and closing statement of affairs. It has two sides, liabilities and assets. Similar to balance sheet, we put all the items of assets and liabilities in the beginning period as well as of the ending at the end, and we find out opening and closing capital. So statement of affair is used to find out opening capital and closing capital. For calculating opening capital, you have to prepare opening statement of affairs, and for knowing closing capital, you have to prepare closing statement of affairs. In the statement of affairs, on asset side, you will record all the assets and liability side, all the liabilities. Difference will be the capital. You can see the format of statement of affairs. It is similar to balance sheet. Statement of affairs as at, if it is opening, then you will write opening date. If it is closing, then you have to write closing date. On asset side, all the opening assets are written. On liability side, all the liabilities are written. And the difference will come on the liability side, balancing figure, that is opening capital. Similar statement of affair is prepared for the closing date, in which all the closing assets are written, assets at the end are written, liabilities at the end are written, and the difference will come on the liability side, that will be your closing capital. So the basic purpose of preparing statement of affairs is knowing the opening and closing capital. So dear students, we are understanding statement of affairs method. Once the amount of capital both at the beginning and at the end is computed with the help of statement of affairs, a statement of profit and loss is prepared to ascertain the exact amount of profit or loss made during the year. So after statement of affairs, you have to prepare statement of profit and loss. The difference between the opening and closing capital represents its increase or decrease, which is to be adjusted for withdrawal made by the owner or any fresh capital introduced by him during the accounting period in order to arrive at the amount of profit or loss made during the period. So, let us see how the statement of affairs, that means how the statement of profit and loss account is prepared. You can see the format, statement of profit and loss for the year ended. In that, first of all, you have to write capital at the end of the year that you have obtained from the closing statement of affairs. So first you have to write closing capital, capital at the end of the year. In that, you have to add drawing made by the owner during the year. From that, you will minus any additional capital introduced by the owner during the year. So first closing capital, in that you will add drawing minus additional capital introduced during the year. So you will get adjusted capital at the end of the year. From this adjusted capital at the end of the year, you have to minus capital at the beginning of the year. That means opening capital, which we have found from the opening statement of affairs. So finally, you will get the answer profit or loss made during the year. So this is a statement of profit or loss for the year ended. Let us try to understand statement of affair method with the help of illustration. From the following information extracted from the records of Messrs. Sidhu, capital at the beginning of the year is 1,20,000. Capital at the end of the year is 2,00,000. So opening capital and closing capital is already given. Capital brought in by the proprietor during the year is ₹50,000. Withdrawal by the proprietor during the year is 30,000. Calculate the profit for the year end. So here you can see opening and closing capital is already given. So you have not to prepare opening and closing statement of affair. If opening and closing capital is not given, then we have to prepare opening and closing statement of affairs. Additional capital is also given ₹50,000 and drawings made by the owner is given 30,000. So we have to directly prepare statement of profit and loss. You can see the solution. Statement of profit and loss is given here. First we have to write closing capital, that means capital as on March 31st 2017, which was given 2,00,000. In that you will add drawing made during the year, so that is 30,000. So total 2,30,000. From that you have to minus additional capital introduced by the owner during the year, which is 50,000 given. So you will get adjusted capital at the end 1,80,000. And from that you have to minus opening capital, that is capital in the beginning, which is 1,20,000. So 60,000 is the profit made by the owner during the year. This answer, if comes in minus, then that is the loss made by the owner. So I think you must have understood how to calculate profit by preparing statement of affairs. See one more example. Following information of an accounting year is given. Opening capital 60,000, drawing 5,000, capital added during the year 10,000, and closing capital is 90,000. Calculate the profit or loss for the year. So we will directly prepare statement of profit and loss. Because opening and closing capital is given, so we have not to prepare opening and closing statement of affairs. So see the statement of profit and loss. First of all, capital at the end 90,000. In that you will add drawing made during the year 5,000. So total is 95,000. From that you have to minus additional capital introduced 10,000. So adjusted capital comes 85,000. From that you have to minus opening capital, which is 60,000. So 25,000 is your answer, and this is the profit made by the owner during the year. वन मोर इलस्ट्रेशन, मयंक डज नॉट कीप प्रॉपर रिकॉर्ड्स ऑफ हिज बिजनेस. ही गिव्स यू द फॉलोइंग इंफॉर्मेशन. ओपनिंग कैपिटल इज गिवन, क्लोजिंग कैपिटल इज गिवन, ड्रॉइंग इज गिवन, कैपिटल एडेड ड्यूरिंग द ईयर दैट मीन्स एडिशनल कैपिटल इज गिवन, कैलकुलेट द प्रॉफिट और लॉस फॉर द ईयर. सो डायरेक्टली वी विल प्रिपेयर स्टेटमेंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस. यू कैन सी हियर ऑन स्क्रीन स्टेटमेंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस इज सोन. क्लोजिंग कैपिटल प्लस ड्रॉइंग माइनस एडिशनल कैपिटल, सो यू विल गेट एडजस्टेड कैपिटल एट द एंड. एंड फ्रॉम दैट कैपिटल इन द बिगिनिंग ओपनिंग कैपिटल इज सब्ट्रैक्टेड, सो यू गेट 17,500, दैट इज द नेट प्रॉफिट फॉर द ईयर. इलस्ट्रेशन नंबर 4. इन दिस इलस्ट्रेशन यू कैन सी विकास मेंटेन्स हिज बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट ऑन सिंगल एंट्री सिस्टम. ही प्रोवाइड्स फॉलोइंग इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम हिज बुक्स. फाइंड आउट एडिशनल कैपिटल इंट्रोड्यूस इन द बिजनेस ड्यूरिंग द ईयर. सो द क्वेश्चन इज यू हैव टू फाइंड एडिशनल कैपिटल. ओपनिंग कैपिटल इज गिवन, क्लोजिंग कैपिटल इज गिवन, ड्रॉइंग मेड ड्यूरिंग द ईयर इज गिवन, एनी वन प्रॉफिट इज ऑल्सो गिवन. सो वी हैव टू फाइंड एडिशनल कैपिटल. सो यू हैव टू जस्ट फॉलो द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस फॉर्मेट. यू कैन इजिली गेट द डिफरेंस अमाउंट एज एडिशनल कैपिटल. सो एडिशनल कैपिटल इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल एट द एंड प्लस ड्रॉइंग. That means first two point of the statement, from that minus capital in the beginning and plus profit. So you will get rupees 20,000, and that is the additional capital introduced by the owner. So here equation is prepared from the statement of profit and loss. I think you can understand this. It is very easy. First two items are added, which is given in the statement of profit and loss. Capital in the beginning we minus, that is opening capital we minus, so that is subtracted. And finally the profit amount which we get, that is also here subtracted. So you get additional capital. One more illustration. Mohan maintains books on single entry system. He gives you the following information. Capital on 1st April 15,200. Capital on 31st March 16,900. Drawing made during the year 4,800. And capital introduced on 1st August 2018. You are required to calculate the profit or loss made by the Mohan. So there is no problem here also. You have to just follow the format. You can see closing capital is written first, in that drawing is added, from that additional capital is subtracted, so you get adjusted capital 19,700, and from that you have to minus opening capital, so finally you are getting the profit 4,500. So these were different exercises in which we found profit by preparing statement of profit and loss. Opening capital and closing capital was ready-made given, so we have not prepared opening and closing statement of affairs. Now let us see some exercise on preparation of statement of affairs. That means when either opening capital or closing capital is not given, then you have to prepare statement of affairs. Mr. Mehta started his ready-made garment business on April 1st, 2016 with a capital of rupees 50,000. So this is opening capital because he started business with this capital. He did not maintain his books according to the double entry system. During the year, he introduced fresh capital of 15,000. So this is an additional capital. So opening capital and additional capital ready-made given. He withdrew rupees 10,000 for personal use. So this is a drawing. On March 31st, 2017, his assets and liabilities are as follow. So closing assets and closing liabilities are given. Total creditors 90,000, total debtors 125,600, स्टॉक 24750, कैसेट बैंक 24980. कैलकुलेट प्रॉफिट और लॉस मेड बाय मिस्टर मेहता ड्यूरिंग द फर्स्ट ईयर ऑफ हिज बिजनेस यूजिंग द स्टेटमेंट ऑफ अफेयर्स मेथड. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हियर ओपनिंग कैपिटल इज गिवन, एडिशनल कैपिटल इज ऑल्सो गिवन, ड्रॉइंग इज ऑल्सो गिवन, ओनली द क्लोजिंग कैपिटल इज नॉट गिवन. सो वी विल फर्स्ट फाइंड क्लोजिंग कैपिटल बाय प्रिपेयरिंग क्लोजिंग स्टेटमेंट ऑफ अफेयर्स, दैट मीन्स स्टेटमेंट ऑफ अफेयर्स ऑन 31st March 2017. So you see, first statement of affair is prepared and it is a closing statement of affair. All the assets are written on the asset side, which are given in the exercise. Cash at bank, debtor, stock. All the liabilities are written on the liability side. Creditors, 90,000. Then, after writing assets and liabilities, you have to find the difference. Your difference will come on the liability side, and that is 85,330, and that is the closing capital. This is a balancing figure. So now we have closing capital also, and opening capital is also already given in the question. Now we will prepare statement of profit and loss to find profit or loss made during the year. Here on screen you can see the statement of profit and loss is prepared. Statement of profit or loss for the year ended 31st March 2017. First closing capital is written as we found right now, 85,330. In that drawing is added 10,000. From that additional capital is subtracted. So you are getting adjusted capital. Then from that you have to minus opening capital, which is 50,000 given. So finally you are getting 30,330, and that is your profit made during the year. So in this exercise we prepared statement of affair for the closing period, and we prepared statement of profit and loss. One more illustration. Krishan started his business on April 1st, 2018 with a capital of Rs. 1 lakh. On 31st March 2019, his assets were cash, stock, debtors and plant. Four assets are given. He owed Rs. 12,000 to sundry creditors, so it is a liability, and 10,000 to his brother on that date. So liability, one is 12,000 of creditor and 10,000 of brother's loan. He withdrew rupees 2,000 per month for his personal expense, ascertain his profit. Dear student, here opening capital is already given. Closing capital is not given, so we will find by preparing closing statement of affairs. Thereafter, drawing is given, but 2,000 rupees per month. So you have to keep in mind the period of drawing, 2,000 into 12. So 24,000 will be the drawing. Here we will first prepare closing statement of affairs. So you can see the closing statement of affairs is prepared. All the assets are written on the asset side, all the closing assets. Cash, stock, debtors and plant. Liability, sundry creditor and brother's loan is written on the liability side. Then you will make total, so difference will come on the liability side, that is 1,32,000, and that 1,32,000 is the closing capital. So now we have the figures of opening capital as well as the closing capital. Now we will prepare the statement of profit and loss. In the statement of profit and loss, first of all, we will write the capital as on March 31st, 2019, that means closing capital, which we right now found. In that you will add the drawings. And drawing is 2000 into 12, so 24,000. So 1,56,000. Additional capital is not given in the question. We will minus capital as on 1st April 2018, that is 1 lakh rupees. So finally we are getting 56,000, that is the profit made during the year 2018 and 19. 56,000. Next illustration. Ram Prasad keeps his books on single entry system, and from them and the particulars supplied, the following figures were gathered together on 31st March 2019. Book debt, rupees 10,000. Now book debt means debtors. Remember, it is not bad debt, it is book debt. Book debt means debtors, and debtor is one of the current asset. Cash in hand, 510. Stock in trade, rupees 6,000. Furniture and fittings, 1,200. Trade creditors, 4,000. Bank overdraft, 1,000. So all these are the assets and liabilities on 31st March 2019. Because it is very clearly written. Ram Prasad stated that he started business on 1st April 2018 with cash of rupees 6,000 paid into bank. So this is the opening capital, but stock valued at rupees 4,000. So he has cash of rupees 6,000 and 4,000 rupees stock as the opening capital. During the year, he estimated his drawing to be rupees 2,400. You are required to prepare the statement showing the profit for the year after writing off 10% for depreciation on furniture and fittings. So in this question, opening capital is given. For the closing statement of affair, different assets and liability information is given. So first of all, we will prepare closing statement of affairs. And we have to also keep in mind, 10% depreciation on furniture and fittings will be calculated. So see, opening statement of affair is given. Because he has bank balance 6,000 and stock 4,000. So opening capital is 10,000. Without preparing this, you can note it down 10,000 as opening capital. Thereafter, closing statement of affairs, you can see here on the screen. Different assets are on the asset side written. Book debt, that is debtor 10,000. Cash in hand, stock. Important point, furniture and fittings 1200, from that 10% depreciation will be subtracted 120, 10% of 1200, 120, so 1080 will be the closing value of the furniture. Liability side, trade creditors and bank overdraft, which is given in the question. So the difference is coming 12,590, that is the closing capital. So here, we have prepared opening statement of affair and closing statement of affair, and we found opening and closing capital. Now we will prepare the statement of profit and loss. See the statement of profit and loss for the year ended 31st March 2019. First of all, you will record capital as on March 31st 2019, that is closing capital 12,590, which we found by preparing closing statement of affair. In that you will add drawing 2400. There is no additional capital given in the question. So 14,990. From that you will minus opening capital 10,000. So profit is 4,990. Let us see one more illustration. Hari maintains his books of account on single entry system. His books provide the following information. You can see different assets and liabilities are given here. On 1st April 2018,
and 31st March 2019. So opening and closing assets and liabilities are given for opening date and closing date. Furniture is given, stock is given, sundry debtors are given, cash balance, sundry creditors, bills receivable, loan and investment. His drawing during the year were 5,000. Depreciate furniture by 10% and provide a reserve for bad and doubtful debt at 10% on sundry debtors. So here two adjustments are given, one for depreciation, second is for provision for bad and doubtful debt. Prepare the statement showing the profit for the year. Now for preparing the statement of profit and loss, we first need closing capital and opening capital, which is not given in this exercise. So you will first prepare closing statement of affair and opening statement of affair, and you will get your opening and closing capital. Let us prepare. You can see the statement of affair is prepared here. On 1st April 2018, all the assets, opening assets are written and opening liabilities written. So difference is coming 35,000. So this is opening capital. So this is a statement of affair on opening date. In that you have to take the opening liabilities and opening assets which are given in the question. That means on 1st April 2018. Thereafter, closing statement of affair, that means on 31st March 2019, in that you have to take all the assets of closing date and all the liabilities of the closing date. So furniture 2000, from that 10% depreciation you have to minus, so 200 rupees minus, so 1800, stock 30,500, sundry debtors 34,000, from that you have to provide for 10% reserve for doubtful debt, so it will come 30,600 in outer column. Cash balance, bills receivable, investment. Dear student, here you have to remember while recording the assets, there may be some assets which are given in the opening balance, that means on 1st April, but they are not given in the closing, so you have to copy them, because assets in the beginning would be definitely there in the business on the closing date. Liabilities are sundry creditor 19,000 given, loan is given 5,000. So all the assets and liabilities are recorded. So difference will come 53,900, that is the closing capital. Now we will prepare statement of profit or loss on the closing date. First, capital as on 31st March 2019, 53,900 we found by preparing closing statement of affair on 31st March 2019. In that you will add drawing 5,000. In this question additional capital is not given, so we have not recorded. From that you will minus the opening capital, that is capital as on April 1st 2018 35,000. So finally you are getting profit made during the year 23,900. So this is statement of profit and loss. So in this exercise we understood statement of affairs for opening date as well as the closing date. If it is given, if opening capital and closing capital is ready-made given, then you have not to prepare opening and closing statement of affair. But when not given, you have to prepare. If opening capital is given, then you have not to prepare. If closing capital is given, then also you have not to prepare. So when not given, then you will prepare the statement of affairs. After understanding the first method, now we are trying to understand second method, that is conversion method. The first method was the statement of affairs method. Now the second method is the conversion method, in which we will try to understand so many things. Preparing trading and profit and loss account and the balance sheet. To prepare proper trading and profit and loss account and the balance sheet, one need complete information regarding expenses and incomes and assets and liabilities. In case of incomplete record, details of some items like creditors, cash, purchases, debtors, cash sales, other cash payment and receipts are easily available.
But there are number of other items detailed which will have to be ascertained in an indirect manner by using logic of double entry.
So this method is somewhat complicated because entire incomplete records we are trying to convert into the complete one, which is a difficult task because we do not have all the records, and here we are trying to prepare trading account and profit and loss account. In the statement of affairs method, we do not prepare trading account and profit and loss account. We just prepare one statement of profit and loss based on the opening and closing capital. But in this method, we will try to prepare trading account and profit and loss account systematically like double entry system by converting incomplete records into the complete one. Preparing trading and profit and loss account and the balance sheet. So the most common items that are missing and have to be worked out as such are: you have to find out opening capital, then credit purchase, credit sales, bills payable accepted, bills receivable received, payment to creditors, payment to debtors, any other cash and bank related items. So these items we have to find out. So first we will understand how to find out all these items. First, ascertainment of credit purchase. The credit purchase figure is not usually available from the incomplete record because they maintain only the cash transactions. So credit purchase information is not available. It is quite possible that some other information related to creditor may also be missing. Therefore, by preparing the total creditor account, credit purchase can be ascertained as the balancing figure. So here we will prepare creditor's account. In that we will record available information and we will try to find amount of credit purchase. So you can see the format of creditor's account. First of all, credit side, by balance brought down, that means opening creditors. If any amount paid to creditor is given, that you will write on the debit side to cash paid. If any check issued to creditor, you will write on the debit side to bank, because this information is available from the cash book. We know when we make payment to creditor, we record creditor's account debit to cash or to bank. So debit side we recorded to cash and to bank. If any bills payable is accepted, then debit side we will write bills payable. You all are aware journal entry for the bills payable, creditor's account debit to bills payable. So creditor's account debit side we recorded bills payable, accepted. When we make payment to creditor and if any discount is received from the creditor, then it will go on the debit side, because you know the journal entry. When we make payment to the creditor and discount is received, we record the entry creditor's account debit to cash account to discount received. So creditor's account debit to cash to discount received. So creditor's account debit side you will write to discount received. We are just posting the journal entries. Purchase return. If any goods is returned to the creditor, we pass the entry creditors to purchase return. So creditors account debit side you will write to purchase return. On the credit side, opening creditor, then bank, that means check dishonored, bills payable if dishonored. Thereafter, If the closing creditors are available, that you will write on the debit side to balance credit down. Difference you will get on the credit side, and that would be your credit purchase. So all this information you have to collect and you have to record in a systematic way, then you will be able to get credit purchase. See the illustration number 10. From the following transactions relating to Messrs. Kishan Food Suppliers, calculate the value of credit purchase. Opening balance of creditor is given, closing balance of creditor is given, payment made in cash is given, discount received is given. So let us prepare creditors account. You can see here creditors account is prepared. Credit side, first of all, opening balance, by balance brought down 80,000. Debit side, last item to balance, credit down 50,000, closing creditor. Debit side, cash amount, that is cash paid to creditor 85,000. Discount received 2,000. So difference you are getting on the credit side, rupees 97,000, and that is your credit purchase. So in this way, you have to prepare creditors account in order to find out credit purchase. One more illustration. Following information is given of an accounting year. Opening creditors given, cash paid to creditors given, return outward. That means purchase return. And closing creditors are given. Calculate the credit purchase. So in creditors account, you will record in this way. Credit side, by balance brought down, opening creditor. Debit side at last, to balance carried down, 12,000. Cash paid to creditor on debit side, 15,000. Purchase return, debit side of creditors account, 1,000. So the finally difference you are getting on the credit side, rupees 13,000, that is your credit purchase. So similar type of one more illustration is given here, you can see. Even it is given in your textbook also. Now you have understood the creditor's account. You can see here the calculation is given. Second item, how to find credit sales. In order to find credit sales, we will prepare total debtors account. Similar to creditors account, we will prepare total debtors account. Let us see the format. In the debtors account debit side, first of all, you will write to balance brought down, that is opening debtor, and on credit side, last item, by balance carried down, closing debtors. If cash received from the debtor, then credit side it will come, by cash, by bank. Because journal entries, cash account debit, bank account debit, two debtors. If discount is allowed to debtor, it will come on the credit side. Because journal entries, cash account debit, bank account debit, discount allowed account debit, two debtors. If any bad debt, then it will go on credit side. Because journal entry for the bad debt is bad debt to debtors. So debtors account credit side. If sales return is there, it will go on credit side because journal entry is sales return account debit to debtors. If bill is received, then credit side because entry is bills receivable account debit to debtors. If bills receivable is dishonored, then it will go on debit side. If check is dishonored, it will go on debit side. After making total, you will find the difference. So difference will come on the debit side and that will be your credit sales balancing figure. So in this way, by preparing debtors account, we find amount of credit sales. Let us understand by illustration. The following information is obtained from the books of Mohanlal Traders. Opening debtors, closing debtors are given. Cash received from the debtor is given, discount allowed is given, bills receivable, bad debt, and you have to find credit sales. So let us prepare debtors account. You can see here in the screen, debtor's account is prepared. All the items are recorded at their particular place. And finally, we are getting difference on the debit side, 1,14,000, that is the amount of credit sales. So as per the format you have to record, you have to keep the item, you will get the amount of credit sales. Illustration number 14. Debtors in the beginning, ₹30,000, opening debtor. Sales on credit during the year, 75,000. Credit sale is ready made given. Cash received from the debtor during the year, 35,000. Return inward, that means sales return, ₹5,000. Bills receivable drawn, 25,000. Find the balance of debtors at the end of the year. That means we have to find closing debtors, assuming that there were bad debt during the year 2000. So we will prepare the debtors account, opening debtors on debit side, closing debtors on credit side, last item. Credit sale is given, so that we will write on the debit side because entry is debtors to sales. So debtors account debit side. Sales return and cash received will be on the credit side. Bills receivable received on the credit side. Bad debt also on credit side. So finally, closing debtor will come on the credit side, and that is 38,000. Third point, ascertainment of bills receivable and bills payable. While all details relating to the bills receivable and bills payable are available, but the figures of the bills received and bills accepted during the year are not given. In such a situation, total bills receivable account and total bills payable account can be prepared and the missing figures can be ascertained as the balancing figure. So one more format of bills receivable account. First of all, bills receivable opening balance you will write on the debit side to balance brought down. If any bill is received, then debit side it will come sundry debtor, because journal entry is bills receivable account to debtors. If check is dishonored, then credit side by bank. If bill is dishonored, then credit side by sundry debtors. And finally, balance carried down, that is closing bills receivable. Similar to bills receivable account, format of bills payable account. Bills payable, opening balance on the credit side, by balance brought down. Debit side, last item to balance carried down, closing balance. If bill is accepted, then on credit side, by sundry creditor, because entry is sundry creditors to bills payable. So bills payable account, credit side, you will write sundry creditors. If bill amount is matured and amount is paid, so debit side you will write to bank. If bill is dishonored, debit side you will write sundry creditors. So this is the format of bills receivable and bills payable account. Now let us see the illustration. For example, consider the following data available from the records of Messrs. S.S. Senapati. Opening bills receivable given, opening bills payable given, bills dishonored given, bills payable dishonored given, closing bills payable given, bills collected during the year is given, closing bills receivable given, and prepare bills receivable and bills payable account. You have not to remember this format, you have to just remember the entries and you have to just do the posting. So here bills receivable account is prepared, all the items are recorded as given, and similar to that bills payable account is also prepared. So dear student, I have tried to explain you how to find credit sales, how to find credit purchase, how to find the amount of total bills receivable and total bills payable. So thank you very much. Please like this video. And if you have any problem, any doubt, you can put in the comment section and you can ask your doubt. You can share my video with more your friends. Many videos I have prepared on class 11 and class 12 accountancy subject. You can go through and you can add more and more number of your friends to my channel. Please try to subscribe my channel. Thank you very much. Take care.